Looking audience we've ever played for, like, you guys are fucking beautiful tonight. This one's called 7 Foot Jockey. When he was born, he was tall. He was a very, very, very long baby. And as he grew up, he reached 6 foot. By the age of 18, he was 7 foot 3, yeah. And he had to find a job. His hobby was hanging around with horses in the stables. And he'd always dreamed of being a jockey, riding to victory in the derby. But everybody said, "You're too tall." And everybody said, "You'll break the horse. You'll never pass the winning post for joy. Your height dictates you'll always be a stable boy." Well, he accepted he was tall, but he didn't want to try his hand at basketball. And the dream, it never died, but the horse shot away from between his legs every time he tried. The veils between our world and the mystical world, they're really thin at the moment. It's a really good time to bring back spirits from the dead. So we're going to bring back the greatest ever spirit of the dead. We're going to bring back Lady Diana right here tonight with a bit of funk voodoo. Diana, show the children how to love again. If only we could bring back Diana, show the children how to live again. So come on, comrades, grab your shovels, grab your spades. Let's head down to the graves, bring back lunches, lemonades. We'll take up Diana's bones, ingest the powder through our noses. Then we'll all have a part of Diana in our hearts. To this land, if only we could bring back Diana. The power of resurrection's in our hands. So come on, comrades, grab your shovels, grab your spades. Let's head down to the graves, bring back lunches, lemonades. We'll take up Diana's bones, ingest the powder through our noses. Then we'll all have a part of Diana in our hearts. Cheers for respecting Diana. Next one's all about magic mushrooms. But I wasn't slipping. I was walking to the shops, heavy slippers, they didn't have proper grips. But I wasn't slipping, I was tripping, tripping inside and slipping around in my mind, tripping inside and having a wonderful time. With my trunks on, I was swimming in the sea. With my trunks on, having fun. The police car pulled me over and he said, "What you doing? You're lying in your trunks in the middle of the motorway. We got a 7 mile tailback." I looked up at the policeman and I said, "Where's the water gone?" I looked up at the policeman and I said, "Well, I have to go. Excuse me, I'm tripping, tripping inside and slipping around in my mind." Tripping inside and having a wonderful time. I was drowned down the road when I ran out of petrol. I was drowned down the road when the needle said I had no gas in the tank. So I pushed my car to the nearest petrol station. I looked in my pockets, I only had £2. So I bought 2 sausage rolls and a curly whirly. I looked for my car but my car was nowhere to be found. Then I remembered I don't even drive. Let me slip us again and say, well, I'm tripping out, tripping out, tripping out, tripping out, tripping all day to day. And I'm, well, I'm tripping out, tripping out, tripping out, tripping out, tripping my life away. And I'm tripping, tripping inside and slipping around in my mind, tripping inside and having a wonderful time. Cheers. Right, I always ask a question at the start of this and I never get the right answer. But there's a few familiar faces, so I'm going to ask. What do you do when you've got a massive pile of shit that you need to get rid of? That's right, you hire a skip. If you're ripping out a bathroom, you got new fittings to fit. Smashing the shower unit into pieces and breaking the bargain to bits. A little bit of renovation could create a lot of mess. The rubble is piling up, causing trouble, and you don't think you can handle the stress. You need to hire a skip. Leave it on the road outside your house while you fill it with shit. There's so much shit you can fit inside a skip. Put it by the week, good, it'll save you several trips to the tip. If you're knocking down a fountain or you're chopping down a tree, remodeling your your garden. You got 50 plastic sacks of debris. You need somewhere to dump shit, to chuck all your crap in. You gotta get your hands on a big trash can, giant metal fucking bin. You need to hire a skip, just for a bit. To leave it on the road outside your house while you fill it with shit. There's so much shit you can fit. What's that skip? Put it on the weak and it'll take you several steps to the tip. Octogenarian Revolution. It's about old people kicking the shit out of Chavez. With electrical tips, so I know that you won't escape. You're a chaver and a chaver, and I'm an old age pensioner in my 80s. You kick your ball off my wall, day and night. Policeman, stop you on the hat 10,000 times in the past. So I'm taking the law into my own hands. And these old hands of mine, yeah, they're going to be brutal. And these old hands of mine, no, they don't fuck around. They don't fuck around. We were trained by the army to kill. As a bill, was nothing compared to the golden wave of 2 days trying to cut hobbits. What does an area revolution do? Well, let's give it up for our drummer who sent us to Africa! Give it up for the world! Spud's gonna raffle up! He's gonna have a raffle for his newcastle at the end! it. And these old hands of mine, yeah, they're going to be brutal. And these old hands of mine, no, they don't fuck around. They don't fuck around. Oh, we were trained by the army to kill. Casimir was nothing compared to the current wave of two days trying to get comic strips. A monk got a quill and a scroll and he wrote down what he thought. He'd act around the church, appointed by the Pope. His spirit thick was meat and his spirit crude was poor. He didn't give a trend, he never followed fashion. He taught Christianity to many Anglo-Saxons. Lived in Jarrow, we drank fine beef. Shares to where he's the venerable beef. There used to be a monk, got a quill and a scroll, and he wrote down what he thought. He'd act out of the church, funded by the Pope. Spiritism was big and his spirit was full. Didn't come for trends, he never followed fashion. Taught Christianity to many Anglo-Saxons. Lived in Jarrow, drank fine beef. Chairs still there, he's the venerable beef.
Was on first as well because he was fucking amazing, mate. So it was so good. And we're gonna do one more tune now and then you've got Feed the Elk. What a night. It's Halloween, so we've got to do Freaky Ghosts, really. Dave's gonna strap on the helmophone and we're gonna get spooky. Thank you. target house on Hampton Hill. The phones and stores and souls could kill the big bodies in their basement still. Local kids, they find the thrills and they walk up there in the dark. They tear each other's apart. On that great big ominous door, been locked up tight since 64. Holding the roof and roaming on the floor. Emanating evil from the start of the call. Like an apple, killed by the devil, then thrown away. And every single year come Halloween, the local town folks where they've seen the strange lights of the night like the buildings alive. Where they go close, you can hear the cries of the people who died inside that night. Out on Hampton Hill. Another thing you should have stuck to the tree. Another thing you should have stuck to the tree. Cheers for being Freaky Ghosts.